Trees recognize the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they express their love, yet these trees are not burdened to do so. They're not muqallaq. The stones recognize the speciality of Rasulullah, and they express their love and obedience, yet they are not burdened to do so. The animals and birds recognize the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they express their love, yet they are not burdened to do so. Great prophets of Allah, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, Allahu ya'allam min ummati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, make us from the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muslims of every era recognize the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they sacrifice their life for the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If anybody has neglected Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his teachings, it is the Muslims of this era, it is Muslims that you suffer at. If anybody does not value the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the speciality of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my Muslim brothers, it is time to say, it is you and I. If anybody is neglecting the rights of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yet again, it is time to say that it is you and I. Which teaching of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam do we embrace today? And which teaching of Kuffar do the Muslims not embrace today? Are we the Quran? The love Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had for this ummah? Are we the Quran? The love Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had for you and I? Have we forgotten the wounds that were inflicted on the person of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because of this ummah? Have we forgotten the blood that rolled down the cheeks of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because of this ummah? Have we forgotten the tears he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shed for you and I, shed for this ummah? Today, we have forgotten Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today, we have no time for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today, we have no value for Rasulullah. We have no value for his teachings. Yet, O Muslim, I ask you, when did Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam neglect you? Did he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ever forget you? Did he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ever neglect you? When was the time that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forgot you? I swear by Allah, no what did he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ever forget his ummah? You spend the night in your cozy bed with your wife and children. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to spend the night worrying and crying about you. Tears are flowing from your Nabi's eyes. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is in prostration. He remains in this state the entire night. One word is flowing from the lips of Rasulullah. O Allah, in to azib him. If you punish my ummah, O Allah, you know, فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُهُمْ, they are your servants. وَإِنَّ تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. O Allah, if you forgive the ummah of Rasulullah, O Allah, you so easy can forgive the ummah because you are the Rahman, you are the Rahim. O Allah, if you forgive them, you are the Almighty, you are the All-Wise. O Muslim, today you have forgotten Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today you neglect the rights of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When did this Nabi ever forget you? Even in the Battle of Badr, when the state of your forefathers was such that they are 313, your forefathers were only 313. They have never fought before. They are hungry. They are thirsty. They are tired. This is the condition of your forefathers. They are carrying broken sticks. They are carrying broken spades. And they are going to fight one of the superpowers of the time. The odds today are that your forefathers will be wiped from the face of the earth. The odds today are that there will remain no Muslim on the face of the earth till the day of judgment. My brother, what is the concern of Rasulullah? He is crying for you. His hands are raised. Oh Allah, I beg you, what is going to become of my ummah today? Oh Allah, what is going to become of my ummah today? Oh Allah, you know, innahum khufatun, they have come walking, they are barefooted. Oh Allah, mount them. Allahumma innahum khurafun. Oh Allah, they have no clothes. Oh Allah, their clothes are torn. Close them. Oh Allah, they are hungry. They have come hungry. Oh Allah, feed them. Oh Allah, I beg you, Allahumma intuhlas hazil isaba la tuban. Oh Allah, I beg you, if this group of Muslims is destroyed today, you will never be worshipped. My brother, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam keeps on praying. He is standing, he is under rain, he is looking towards the heaven, he is facing Qibla. My brother, Abu Bakr cannot bear the condition of Rasulullah. He screams out to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Nabi, you are crying enough for your ummah. Allah will not disgrace with you regarding your ummah. Allah will help you. This was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And today we have forgotten Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I ask you, what was your state in history? Who were you? What were you? And that is because we were nothing. We were this. We were not even worthy of mention. Our forefathers were in the depths of ignorance. Our forefathers were in the depths of kufr. They worshipped the moon. They worshipped the sun. They shed blood over petty arguments. They even buried their daughters alive. Every sin that you can think of was right in their society. This is who we were. This is where we came from. The Almighty Allah showed mercy upon us. And He chose us to become the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And He named named Muslimin. Then he gave us such a status because of Rasulullah, that the Quran praised it, and the Quran will keep on praising until the day of judgment. Open the book of Allah. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas, ummati Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You don't realize that you are the best people raised for mankind. Then he gave you such a status, then he gave you such a blessing because of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like he blessed no nation before you, like he blessed no form before you. The Almighty Allah is saying, O Ummati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you not know that I have destroyed many people before you through flood and through famine because of their disobedience? O Ummati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of your Nabi, you have become so precious to me that I will not punish you like I punished those people before you. I will not destroy you like I destroyed those people before you. O Ummati Muhammad, beauty was not halal for those people before you. They would make jihad, they would sacrifice, they would strive, they would gather the mali ghanimat, they would gather the booty. I would send a fire from the heavens, and this fire would eat the mali ghanimat, it would eat the booty as a sign of acceptance. O Ummati Muhammad, because of your Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have become so precious for me that I have made booty halal for you. Go make the jihad, keep the booty, do with it as you please. O Ummati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you not know that if those people before you did not pray in their churches and synagogues, I would not accept their prayers? O Ummati Muhammad, because of your Nabi, you have become so precious to me that pray inside the masjid, I will accept your prayer. Pray inside the tent, I will accept your prayer. Pray on the street, I will accept your prayer. O Ummati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you not know that because of your Nabi, I have not burdened you like I burdened those people before you? If the children of Israel committed sin, they were disgraced, and they would find the very sin that they have committed written on their doors in the morning. Everybody would see this, all because of your Nabi. If you cannot pray standing up, I will accept your prayer sitting down. If you cannot pray sitting down, I will accept your prayer lying down. If you cannot pray lying down, pray with Isara, I will accept your prayer. If you cannot fast in the month of Ramadan because you are traveling, fast whenever, I will accept your fast. If you cannot perform wudu, perform tayammum, I will accept your fast. O Ummati Muhammad, then I give you Surah Fatiha and the last verses of Baqarah from beneath my arsh, from beneath the arsh of Allah. And I gave you five such things in the month of Ramadan, which I have given to no Ummah before you, which I have given to no nation before you. I will look at you on the first night of Ramadan with mercy. Look at me with repentance, and I promise you, I will never punish you, and I will never put you in Jahannam. My brothers, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, gave us the night of power. He gave us Laylatul Qadr, which is better than the worship of a thousand months. Then he gave us Jummah, and an hour in Jummah, in whichever prayer we make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will accept that prayer. O Ummati Muhammad, you don't realize, you are the Ummati Mazumah. You are the Ummah that has received the mercy of Allah because of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You will enter your grave full of sin, but when you come out of your grave, you will be free of sin. What? Basically, you don't realize that because of your Nabi, on the plane of resurrection, you will be the first to be resurrected. And your faces will have noor on them, and you will be with your Nabi on the raised platform. And when anybody sees you on the plane of resurrection, they will desire, they will make the manna, only if they were from the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O Ummati Muhammad, because of your Nabi, you will be the first to be judged. You will be the first to receive your records in your right hand. You will be the first to cross the fourth Siraj. You will be the first to enter Jannah. You will be the first to enter the right hand doors of Jannah. And there will be 70,000 from amongst you who will enter Jannah without hisab. Allahumma ja'alna minhum. And because of your Nabi, you will make up the half of the inhabitants of Jannah. And all the other nations put together, from Adam alayhi salam to our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will make up the other half of Jannah. You have received all this and much more because of one person. Because of your link with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because you were the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah has given you all this. And how do we repay these favors? That we give priority to the kuffar on their ways over Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his sunnah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is coming with the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu majma'in. Uthman is overjoyed that today the best of all creation is coming to his house. He is following Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He begins to count the footsteps of Rasulullah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells Anu Uthman, why are you counting my footsteps today? He replies, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is this not the days of all days for Uthman and you, the man of all men? Your blessed son is coming to my house today. Out of love and respect for you, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, today, for every step Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam takes to my house, Uthman will be a slave for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.